Hello viewers, welcome to this video lecture series on analysis and design of algorithms. Today's topic of discussion is on traveling salesman problem, and this problem I am teaching under the methodology called as brute force approach. So from the previous few sessions I have been telling all the algorithms that comes under this technique called as brute force approach, and also I told you about the brute force approach, why exactly this method is called as brute force, and moreover you can call it by the name exhaustive search also. So today let me explain you about the traveling salesman problem. Few points about the traveling salesman problem I have written towards the left side of the board. Here you can see that what for this traveling salesman problem or algorithm can be implemented. It is used to find the shortest tour through a given set of n cities that visits each city exactly once before returning to the city where it started. The problem can be stated as the problem of finding the shortest Hamiltonian circuit of the graph. And moreover, what is Hamiltonian circuit? And Hamiltonian circuit is defined as a cycle that passes through all the vertices of the graph exactly once. So I shall be explaining you with an example here. The traveling salesman problem can be modeled by a weighted graph. So a graph is shown here, wherein in a graph you know there are vertices. So these vertices of the graph represents what? Represents cities. Why we are using cities here is because to relate it with the traveling salesman problem, there is a salesperson who will travel from one city to another city, but the condition is that he has to come back to the city from where it started. Suppose now we are having here whatever are the vertices of the graph, we have to call it as cities. So there are four cities here, A, B, C and D. Suppose if he starts from city A, then he has to come back to city A after visiting all the cities. So the condition is that he should not miss any city. So moreover, definitely when he has got so many options, so many routes to reach all cities, his job will be easier if he finds the shortest route. So this is what we are finding here using this algorithm. We also wanted to know which particular route this person can use in order to reach all the cities. That means with less distance, and he has to come back to the city from where he started. We modeled by a graph, as I said, and it is a weighted graph. Weighted graph here means what? The edges are having some weights. These weights represents the distances. So distances will just assume the units as kilometers. So you just see here he has got these many kilometers between the two different between cities. Now how to proceed in order to solve this problem? Starting node we are assuming it as A. Sometimes in the question the starting node will not be mentioned, so you can take it as node A. That means the alphabetical order A, B, C, D, A you can consider it as the starting node. If the cities are represented with numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, then you can take the starting node as 1. So this way you can proceed. Now I'll tell you how exactly you need to find out the shortest route here. So the first thing what you can do is, so let me start from the city A. From A I can reach to B. This one A I can reach it to C, I can reach to C, I can reach to D. First you write in this manner the first three steps. Then what you have to do is from B you can reach to C and you can reach to D also. So A to B, B to C, A to B, B to C, but A to B and from B you can reach even to D. So you will include one more option here so that we can say A to B and B to D. Right, this we have completed. Next, A to C. Yes, A to C is here. From C you can reach to B, C you can reach to D. So C you can reach to B, then we'll include from C we can reach even to D. Then here we have A to D. From A you can reach to D, from D you can reach to B, from D you can reach to C. So that we will write here, from D you can reach to B, also from D you can reach to C. This we will include. So these many permutations we are able to write here for a graph which has got four vertices. So that means for four cities these many permutations are possible. Now not only this permutation, whatever I have written is still not completed. Now you need to proceed because you have to travel to all the salesperson has to visit all the cities from A to B, B to C, means the remaining city is what? C to D. This one, C to D. C to D he has to travel, and here A, C, B, so he has to definitely visit D also, and B to D is here. See, you can see there is a connection between all the cities. Every city is connected to every other city. So we can easily write here whichever city is missed here, that becomes your fourth city. A, D, B, C you need to include. A, B, D. Yes, C is missing. A, C, D. B, A, D, C, B. Okay. So this way you write down. Then one more thing is that he has to come back to the city from where he started. Starting city is what? A. We have taken the starting city as A. So he'll come back to city A. City A, if he takes this route also, he has to come back this route also, this route, this route. Any route definitely has to come back to the city A. Now just find out what are the distances that are there between these cities. Suppose if this is the first one, I'll write here first, second, third route, fourth possible route, fifth possible route, and sixth possible route. So for the first possible route, A to B, you have how much? 10. B to C, 25. C to D, 40. D to A is how much? 45. Here it is, 45. Right? So here what you are writing is, you are writing the lengths. Length means when you combine the distances of all these cities, whatever you get is the total distance. So we call it as length. So I can write down here L equal to. Fine, for the first case. For the second case, similarly, you will find out the value for L. How much it will be? A to C is here, 50. C to B, 25. B to D, 25. And D to A is here, 45. Okay, this way you need to fill for the remaining routes also, which you have written over there. So you got these values. Now definitely the shortest route the traveling salesperson has to select. So when he found these possibilities, so the shortest are here two routes. One is this one, the first one, the here and the last one, 120. So 120 is the smallest value. Definitely has got two options. Now he can go either through this one or one first option, or he can use the last option. The first option is what? 10, 25, 40, 45. So it is for which cities? 10, 25. First one, A to B. He can travel like this. A to B, then B to C, and then C to D. Fine. And then he will be back to A. This is your. So I'll put the arrow direction also. So this is one option. What about the other option? The other option is A, D, C, B, A. Other option is A, D, C, B, and A. This is the second option. So let me show you the steps here. First step is consider city A as the starting and ending point. Definitely we have taken care. Then generate all n minus 1 factorial permutations of the cities. The second step is you are generating n minus 1 factorial permutations. N here is denoting what? N here is denoting the number of cities. Here we have how many? 4 cities. So 4 minus 1 factorial. 4 minus 1 factorial is how much? 3 factorial. The value for 3 factorial is 6. So for 3 factorial it is 6. It means you are going to generate 6 permutations. So and you can see definitely we have 6 permutations here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the permutations what you have written. The first step is what? First you are going to take the starting and ending the same city. You are taking the same city as the starting city and the ending city, and then you are writing down all the 6 permutations. Then the third step is what? Calculate the cost of every permutation and keep track of the minimum cost permutation. So we have calculated here all these values: 120, 145, 145, 125, 125, 120. These are what? The cost of every permutation. And then you are keeping track of the minimum cost. Minimum cost here we found here for the first one and the last one. And then you are returning the permutations with the minimum cost. So finally, whatever is the minimum, that becomes the final value here. The salesperson can use that route in order to carry out his job. So this is a very simple algorithm. When a numerical is asked in the examination, it is easy for the students to score also, because not much complicated steps are here. But since you are learning for the time complexity, you need to at least know what is the time complexity of this algorithm. So the time complexity of this algorithm is n factorial. So I can write down time complexity equal to big O of n factorial. N, whatever are the number of cities, okay, the factorial of that is going to give you the time complexity. Since here we have n as 4, 4 factorial is how much? 4 factorial is 24. So all 24 options are explored here. Exhaustive approach. So this approach always explores all the possible options. This, in our example, n factorial is 24. That means all 24 options we have explored. How will you find out all the 24 options? You can see here. See the very first one. You got how many? 6 permutations. Each permutation is having 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 options. So here 4, 4, 4, 4. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. 24 options are here, which we have explored here. That is how the brute force approach is not a efficient approach, because it is going to explore exhaustively all possible options that are available. So definitely when you are exploring all the possible options, the algorithm will take more time for more bigger value for the input. Since here you are having 4, no problem. But what about if you are having 10 cities? If 10 cities means you will have how much? 9 permutations. And when you take n minus 1 factorial, that means the possible options, it will cross about 3 lakhs. When you are having 15 cities, then definitely it will be above billions. So this approach, normally we call it as a NP hard problem. NP hard problem is non-deterministic. Okay, NP stands for non-deterministic polynomial, and which is not an efficient method here. This particular algorithm can be also implemented using the other approach called as dynamic approach, and the running time complexity of this algorithm is big O of n factorial. Basically we have to see its applications also. There are several applications. Two main important applications I have written over here: the computer wiring, and another is what? The vehicle routing. So that's it in this session. Hope you find this session useful. If you find it useful, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye bye and take care.